It's your boy Indian Guru in the house, back with another dang video. Today's videos is all about some really, really dreamy news and some really, really tough news for all the Arsenal fans. Well, I'm feeling the heat right now by just informing you guys with these news. But nonetheless, we will continue the video. But first, let me always remind you, as I always do, please subscribe to my channel. If you're new to this channel, do subscribe. I post daily Arsenal stuff about every Arsenal fan. Right now, currently, I'm telling more about the transfer news, what Arsenal should sign, what Arsenal are actually signing, and what is the exact update. That is what I'm doing right now. So, please stay tuned and subscribe to our channel. Hit that bell icon so you get notified whenever I post a video. We have a target of reaching 200 subscribers before the end of this month. We have got, I think, somewhere around 7 to 8 days left in this month. So please, guys, if you can, do subscribe to my channel and support me in this journey of mine. So let's go on with the video. Lucas Vazquez to Arsenal. What kind of a shit news is this? Lucas Vazquez is finding it hard to get game time at Real Madrid and is being shockingly linked to Arsenal. Now, I don't understand why, I think even if this were to be true, it would be so difficult for us to agree with Lucas Vazquez on personal terms, because why would somebody leave Real Madrid? He's earning a hell lot of money, but for game time, anybody would leave Barcelona, but nobody would leave Real Madrid. I mean, he's won Champions League with them. Why would he leave? And right now, I think any Real Madrid player would not want to leave Real Madrid, because definitely if they play or not, they would definitely get a Champions League medal. They have a chance of winning a Champions League next season because they have invested a hell lot of money. So there will be a new look Real Madrid. This news is bogus and shit news. If we get Lucas Vazquez, wow, I think that would be a top drawer news. I think a great winger to have. Well, it has been said in French media that Laurent Koscielny has been offered a 2-year deal by Olympique Lyon. Lyon wants Koscielny on a 2-year deal. The 33-year-old wants to have some new challenge. All the best, my capitan. If you leave, I would be, a salute to whatever you did for Arsenal. I think it's a great time. If you can leave, definitely, if we could get some money, definitely we would want to reinvest where Arsenal could improve. And I believe, yeah, he should leave. Kieran Tierney, well, this is a biggest puzzle that Arsenal need to solve. And apparently they have bid 15 million and Celtic have rejected it. I mean, according to David Ornstein, he has mentioned that Arsenal have actually bid 15 million and Celtic believe that is very less. And not only that, I've also heard that Arsenal have offered four players, Tutu, Emil Smith Rowe, Nketiah and Jenkinson. They can choose any one player out of these four and take 15 million so that Kieran Tierney can come to Emirates. I think nobody is ready to take Jenkinson. That's the problem. And 15 million, well, according to John Hartson, he believes that Arsenal are testing waters with Celtic, and I believe 25 million is a fair amount of money because Kieran Tierney is a great talent. And if we believe we don't have money, that is true, we don't have money. So, but David Ornstein also says that Celtic were about to sell Tierney last season itself, but they want to sell to raise funds. So I think 15 million no, but 20 million yes. I think they would meet somewhere in the middle. So maybe if Celtic send a good offer in return so that we could meet it and finally have our man. As I had mentioned, Yannick Carrasco has been suspended by Dalian Yifang for disciplinary reasons, and Yannick Carrasco has actually hit back at Dalian Yifang. He believes that there are certain members in the management of the club who don't like him, who actually don't want him to, have an easy time at his stay at Dalian, and he believes that he's been not, there is some problem in the management that he needs to solve. Well, that's really very, very lame to blame them for your, for your mishaps. If you have to blame your team, I don't think so. Team is going to take that kind of bullshit. And I believe that is, we all know what happens. We're not kids. We know why players do that. They would want to, want to leave that club. Good. keep on forcing the move so that they get fed up and finally, you know, cash in with us lurking to sign you. Well, not only that, the head coach of Dalian Yifang has mentioned that Yannick Carrasco won't play for a long time because disciplinary actions are actually met with very stricter reactions from the club management. So, fair enough. Come to Arsenal, that's it. Osei Tutu has actually, you know, followed VFL Bochum, you know, the second Bundesliga side, on Instagram, and it is believed that he would be on loan next season at VFL Bochum. Go, get us some money, thank you. Funny story, I was actually, you know, waiting to see when would Christopher Nkunku would be again linked to Arsenal this season. We were about to get a loan deal, but PSG declined, you know, at the winter transfer window. So this is the best time, you know, Christopher Nkunku is entering in his last year of his contract, would be available. PSG were looking at a 25 million deal at the winter, but they know that they cannot do that right now. So at a cut price deal, Christopher Nkunku, you know, he could be signed for 15 million, and that is a really good coup. He's a great talent to go forward to. He's not getting game time at PSG. So Christopher Nkunku, and even PSG wants to raise more funds. So I think, yeah, smart buy. It would be 15 million. It would be a very, very great buy. Marcus Schubert, as I had mentioned, that he was actually looking to go somewhere in Germany with Schalke. On Instagram, his girlfriend has shared an image wearing an Arsenal jersey and captioning fitting. What does that mean? It means that Marcus Schubert will definitely be at Arsenal. I think it's really, really funny, because I think Arsenal might have pulled off, might have some balls in their court and might have pulled off some stunning, stunning business that we don't know about. All we have to do is we have to wait and watch. Atletico Madrid are actually behind Hector Bellerin. Atletico Madrid want to sign Hector Bellerin and are willing to part ways with Vitolo and cash. And Arsenal would be foolish to let him go. And Arsenal know that he's a great attacking threat. And we know how Atleti play. So they would require some more, you know, attacking tools. And most importantly, Hector Bellerin has declined. He's happy at Arsenal. That is exactly what he has said. And he would not want to move away from Emirates. Thank you, Hector. My captain, my future captain. The biggest news of the day. And I don't understand why these news actually don't go away. Yeah, I know. AC Milan have actually hired GM Paolo. And why does that GM Paolo want Torreira back? I really don't understand. I mean, it's just like an annoying ex keeps coming back and, you know, fucking up the whole life and ecosystem of Lucas Torreira. Really don't understand why. Well, it has been learned that AC Milan are ready to even go up their bid and offer 31 to 36 million to sign Lucas Torreira from Arsenal. And you know what? Arsenal have actually kept, you know, a transfer amount of 45 million. Yes, if AC Milan bid 45 million and above, Arsenal are ready to part ways and cash in on Lucas Torreira. I think, yes, this is going too much out of hand now. We need a player like Torreira, yes, but not on the terms that, obviously, every player, you know, you should be smart enough. I'm talking to Lucas Torreira. You should be smart enough to change a country where you play. Okay, you're not a kid, you're not naive. You came to Arsenal. Okay, you came to a different country. What did you think? Like, magically or mysteriously, somehow in your sleep, you know, you're sleeping and next day you get up, you suddenly learn English. You fool. If you did not know, and if these were the problems for you that would have developed later on, why the fuck did you come to Arsenal? I respect you as a player, and I respect you, whatever you've done for Arsenal in the first season. I know and I want you to stay, but this behavior, this is very lame. This is really lame. You know, so right now I'm feeling exactly how Dalian Yifang fans and teammates feel about Yannick Carrasco, and same shit things. You know, it's not worse enough, but I think these are some shit things what Lucas Torreira is doing, and obviously AC Milan will definitely try to cash in. I don't think so. 45 million I think would put the speculations to bed, and it's up to Torreira now. I mean, also to Arsenal as well, but I don't want Torreira to leave. But if these news keep coming up, they don't come up without a reason. So if we get more than 45 million, why not? Why not? Fed up, seriously fed up. Well, these were the news. If you haven't still subscribed to my channel, subscribe, guys. Subscribe. What are you waiting for? Please let us reach that 200 subscriber mark before the end of this month. And always, always hit that bell icon.